greetings. The conversation continued with more great questions. Hello there again. My question is that was Jesus sent to all of mankind? I mean, if he was only sent to the lost sheep of Israel, did that mean the New Testament only applied to them then? It is a blessing to hear from you, brother. First, I want to confirm the point you made that Jesus, when he was sent, was in fact sent only to the lost sheep of Israel. But before going deep, we should consider two phrases, sent to and sent for. These have subtly different meanings and implications. Sent to would mean sent with the intention of going to a specific group or individual. Jonah was sent to Nineveh. That means he did not go to Rome so Nineveh could later hear about it. I will prove later Jesus was sent to Israel. Sent for differs because for someone implies an action to accomplish for a group. The group benefits. But for does not require contact with the recipient of the benefit. The easiest example is for future generations. Time may create a barrier that a prophet cannot physically cross, hundreds or thousands of years. I will prove also Jesus was sent for mankind. So back to the theme of my original answer. First, I want to confirm the point you made that Jesus, when he was sent, was in fact sent only to the lost sheep of Israel. This is in fulfillment of what Moses said about him, brother. In Deuteronomy 18, Moses and God describe a prophet who would be from Israel and sent to Israel. Deuteronomy 18:15, "The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among you. From your countrymen you shall listen to him." The prophet mentioned is for Israel. Deuteronomy 18:18, "I will raise up a prophet from among their countrymen like you, and I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that I command him." The prophet mentioned is to them, meaning to Israel or for Israel. Jesus was this prophet, and therefore Jesus was sent only to the people of Israel. Let me support that with a few scriptures. Matthew 15:24, "But he," and this is Jesus speaking, "answered and said, I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." Luke 24:44, "Now he," Jesus, "said to them, these are my words which I spoke to you while I was still with you, that all things which are written about me in the law of Moses and the prophets and the Psalms might be fulfilled." So Jesus himself said that Moses spoke of him. Even the disciples taught that Jesus was the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. Acts 3:22, "Moses said, the Lord God will raise up for you a prophet like me from your brethren. To him you shall give heed to everything he says to you." And also in Acts 7:37, "This is the Moses who said to the sons of Israel, God will raise up for you a prophet like me from your brethren." So Jesus' specific purpose during his ministry was to teach only the people of Israel. But even with that purpose, Jesus still encountered non-Israelites. The Samaritan woman at the well. The whole story is John 4, verse 1 through 26. In summary, John 4, 25 through 26, "The woman said, I know that Messiah, called Christ, is coming. When he comes, he will explain everything to us." And Jesus answered, "I, who speak to you, am he." The Canaanite woman with a sick daughter received a miracle from Jesus because of her faith. Matthew 15:22, "And a Canaanite woman from that region came out and began to cry out, saying, 'Have mercy on me, Lord, Son of David, my daughter is cruelly demon-possessed.' But he did not answer her a word, and his disciples came and implored him, saying, 'Send her away, because she keeps shouting at us.' But he answered and said, 'I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.' But she came and began to bow down before him, saying, 'Lord, help me.'" Another translation said, "worshipped him." "And he answered and said, 'It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the dogs.' But she said, 'Yes, Lord, but even the dogs feed on the crumbs which fall from their master's table.' Then Jesus said to her, 'O woman, your faith is great. It shall be done for you as you wish.' And her daughter was healed at once." A Roman centurion also received a miracle because of his faith. However, God's plan from the beginning was to bless all nations through Abraham's covenant with God. Genesis 18:18, "Seeing that Abraham shall surely become a great and mighty nation, and all the nations of the earth shall be blessed in him." So in the Old Testament, Prophet Moses reveals the scope of humanity which will be blessed by God. In the New Testament, it is also clear that the message is to all nations. 1 Timothy 2:4, "Who desires all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth." John 1:29, "The next day John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, 'Look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world.'" It is important to notice John did not say, "the sins of only Israel," or "only the sins of the Jewish people." Beyond that, the apostles struggled with this new revelation from God. Was the gospel only for Jewish people who accepted their Messiah? It was a completely new idea for them. But God proved his salvation was to Gentiles, or non-Jewish people, as well. God proved it by giving the Holy Spirit to Gentiles. Acts 10:22, "The men replied, 'We have come from Cornelius the centurion. He is a righteous and God-fearing man who is respected by all the Jewish people. A holy angel told him to ask you to come to his house so that he could hear what you have to say.' And he," Peter, "said to them, 'You yourselves know how unlawful it is for a Jew to associate with or to visit anyone of another nation. But God has shown me that I should not call any person common or unclean.'" Peter preaches the facts of the gospel, and then, while Peter was still speaking these words, the Holy Spirit fell upon all those who were listening to the message. All the circumcised believers, meaning the Jews, who came with Peter, were amazed, because the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out on the Gentiles also. "Can anyone withhold the water to baptize these people? They have received the Holy Spirit just as we have." Peter knew that the Holy Spirit signified these Gentiles were believers, born again into God as Jesus had taught. So, brother, the death of Jesus was to establish a new covenant with all mankind, for all mankind, and not just those who physically descended from Abraham. I love the questions you ask, brother. They are so thoughtful and serious. Is there any other evidence Jesus was sent for mankind? John 17:19, Jesus was praying and he said, "For their sakes I sanctify myself, that they themselves also may be sanctified in truth. But I do not ask for these," meaning his disciples, "only, but also for those believing in me through their word." That is for all who become believers all through time. 1 John 1:3, "We proclaim to you what we have seen and heard, so that you also may have fellowship with us. And our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son, Jesus Christ. So Jesus was sent to Israel, fulfilling God's word from Prophet Moses. And Jesus was sent for mankind, fulfilling the prophets and Jesus' own words. Best regards, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.